Yeah, good afternoon. I want to express my gratitude to Dr. Baldev Raj for inviting me here and giving me the opportunity to share about the RuTAG to all through IMF. So this is, I think you have heard enough about this RuTAG, and this is the, actually, if you see the how the problem started is, this is the, if you see in India, this is a strong S&T foundation in basic as well as applied research is there, but the gap is still there in delivering appropriate technology to the rural area or the required clusters, and which affects actually the quality of life and development and so on. And even though if you see the rural technologies per se, it is a very complex kind of a thing because they are region specific, they have been very diffuse and uneven, and that's why the pace is slow. As Dr. Himadri Ghosh also says that the changing agents are also very less, so the people, they are also very few to take this thing ahead. And that's how to, this is just a effort from Dr. Chidambaram's office, and he has conceptualized the thing about Rural Technology Action Group, which is a mechanism started in 2004, which is addressing actually need-based upgradation, and also we are customizing it and full support from the IIT directors and all, and through their support and other teamwork, we have established in 7 IITs. And we are getting these demand-driven technologies are being developed, so that the demand we are getting either from NGOs or from institutions, from state government and so on. So there are these stakeholders are there who are demanding the technologies, and appropriately they have been innovated by IIT teams, which we call at RuTAG centers. So usually, and we have worked with lot of other things also, that non-farm sectors, clusters and other things, I will come back to you. This is the technologies what we have developed. Till now, we have developed more than 50 technologies. They are ready for as a product and field tested, and still are in the field and been upgraded also. So if you see about the artisan and cluster specific, this is, we have addressed the silk, handloom, wool and potter. These are the few things I want to just see. About the silk in Assam and Northeast region, there are a lot of, if you see the silk cluster in Sualkushi, requires lot many equipments like, you know, warping machine, pun winding machines and all. If you see the availability of the shelf, either they are big, they are costly, and they cannot be, you know, customized or as per your specifications. So IIT Guwahati has developed locally made warping machine with the bamboos and all, and which is actually the difference more than 10 times what you can make it. So, you know, that gives the confidence in the local entrepreneur, local people, where the education and other things doesn't come in the way. And they are working very happily about it also. So this is about the silk. Similarly, with the handloom cluster, we have worked. And for wool cluster, see, there are some arts from Jammu Kashmir is there, which they make, you know, felts and all, very beautiful make felts are made, which are inlay designs are there. And they require some pressing through this. So we have made, IIT Roorkee has made this machine. So, and similarly for potter wheels, as Dr. Bhaduria also said, here the customization is very much required. One potter wheel, if you take IIT Kharagpur's potter wheel, when it was tested at Assam, they wanted some tweaking or customization. Suppose if the concept is of the pedal driven or some other things, these people, they are very much comfortable ladies with the sewing machine kind of a concept. So we have to develop certain things, and through RuTAG, I am very glad, and all these IITs also, we have got very good teamwork, and they could do it. So this is what we have addressed. Similarly, value addition for this charcoal kiln and all, you can make it, which is more environment friendly and all. And similarly, Mahua flowers, which you know, a lot of good fragrance is there. Also, it has the high glycemic index. So if you can, and it's a good nutritive source also. So our office, through RuTAG, we have initiated the project. And they have added some value-added products. They have made some sweet or some other things or some proper nutritive things they have developed. And through these catalytic funding projects, a big project Department of Biotechnology had sanctioned, and in Chhattisgarh and Ranchi, these people have worked through NGOs. So this is also one of the success. Similarly, this gravity-based ropeway, some of the things they are actually having the larger impact. Similarly, the recharging of dried water springs. See, water is again a big shortage everywhere. So through this runoff and all, or in Uttarakhand, as Dr. Anil Joshi was indicating, he was the one who indicated the problem to Dr. Chidambaram and how it has evolved with BARC technology, with isotope hydrology technology, plus your geochemical analysis. They could find out ki, and the, there is an altitudinal difference when the radioactivity, the stable isotope of H and O, there is a mass difference is there. And VARC has the expertise and technology where they can map, you know, that this altitude and this is the thing and rainfall, all these data when you see. They have put the artificial, this thing they have done, and then they could revive the dried springs. That is what we want to say, and it is not a one-off kind of a thing. We have taken around 11 dried springs were identified in Himachal Pradesh and other things, and they were revived. Similarly, we have done a lot many other things, and replications, if you see the channel, since the RuTAG is a very different kind of a thing, it will not have the successful entrepreneur or the lucrative market for such things. So different channels are need to be activated, so we could find certain things. Here I would like to say some few things. This is the pit loom and modified Nepali loom. Here is one of the success story, where the KVIB or the Khadi Village Industrial Board from Trivandrum and Kerala, where the conventional pit loom was modified by the RuTAG IIT Madras, and it actually increased the productivity and comfort and quality and also on. So this is one of the things, and they have seeing the success at one or two places, they have ordered some around 60 looms of the modified looms, and that's how it is channelized through the local entrepreneurs again. So this is also the fancy mat at Latur, which is a waste or old saris they are making these mats. They are visually challenged people. And again, IIT Madras, IIT Bombay, they helped and they put this at ease, this warping machine and all they have developed. At the third, this is a design of electronic jacquard on grass mats of Pattamadai. At Tamil Nadu, there are fine weaver are there with grass, they are making the mats. And this is the beautiful designs, if you see the electronic jacquard designs we have given to them. And that's how it is serving them in a better way for getting a good thing. This I wanted to show you. This is the one of the good intervention. Yeah, at the left side, if you see, this is NGO Shashwat, Professor Anand Kapoor, who was from IIT Kharagpur. This was the floating fish cage structure earlier, which was made up of wood having the problems and all. And this is the right side. This is the what we have developed through IIT Bombay. And this is replicated through the Ministry of Tribal Development at state, and it is replicated. So it's a very beautifully done and serving the things. Now here, this is one of the last slides. This is the interaction of ministries we have done also, and they have really shown a lot of interest in the RuTAG technologies. Now through this IMF forum, what I am envisaging is this is a good platform what we have started off, which will creating the supporting and network of local entrepreneurship, and this through integrating systems like as Dr. Smita Mule has said and all, we can work through that. And maybe some deliverables and focus deliverables, if we aim at it, it will be a very good thing. And this is the last slide. I want to give you a big thank you and thanks for patiently listening. Thank you.